What the people of Madagascar are saying is that we have discovered something that we hold the view is capable of dealing with COVID-19. The World Health Organization is asking, does it conform to the protocol that have been prescribed by the World Health Organization? But let us ask ourselves, who prescribed these protocols?
Boo! Yo, what's up, viewers? It's your boy T5 back with another video. Hope you're doing pretty much good and taking good care of yourself. If you're viewing this channel for the very first time, don't forget to subscribe and hit the notification bell so that you can be updated whenever I upload more of these videos. So today's video doesn't have much of my content. I'm just going to share a video of Professor Lumumba's response to some questions that he was asked over the current situation of Madagascar discovering the medicine to COVID-19 and African leaders not having to respond or give the support to what is actually happening. So, ladies and gentlemen, without wasting much of your time, sit back, relax, because this video is about to get real. Without wasting much of your time, ladies and gentlemen, let's get into it.
The truth is that when nature chooses to strike, it strikes in such a devastating manner that no level of human ingenuity can stand in her way. That is how devastating it is. Africa is a continent, as one would say, that has promise. But Africa is a continent that underperforms, is a continent that punches below her weight. Whether you think of her from a political standpoint, you think of her from an economic standpoint, you think of her from a cultural dimension, you think of her from a technological dimension, you think of her from a sporting dimension, there is a sense in which we never quite realize our potential. And of course, when we find ourselves in a situation such as this, we have no shortage of excuses and reasons that we can ascribe to our plight. But I think there is a sense in which we ourselves, as the indigenes of Africa, are also co-authors of our own misfortune. Whether we can say that is the 400 years of slavery or the nearly 100 years of colonization, and the succeeding nearly 60 years of neo-colonization, there is a sense in which we have found ourselves in a situation where we have no faith in ourselves. Our levels of esteem are such that we doubt ourselves so very much and so very fundamentally that even the things that we ought to do, we don't do. And the COVID-19 has served to expose our underbelly, that when we found ourselves confronted with this pandemic, when we examined our hospitals, we found those hospitals wanting. The entire continent of Africa has fewer ICU beds than the country of Germany. When we found ourselves in terms of the hospital beds, we have fewer beds in the entire continent of Africa than there are beds in Spain. And when we found ourselves needing ambulances, we discovered that we have fewer ambulances than the entire country, than the country of Italy. When we found ourselves wanting for ventilators, we discovered that South Korea has more ventilators than all African countries combined. And when we were hungry for masks, we discovered that we didn't even make masks and that Jack Ma from China had to give us masks. And it's only after that we started discovering that we could very well make them. So that my kinsman, whom I've quoted so very often, Ali Mazrui, was very right and remains as right as he was in 1980s, that Africa produces what it does not consume and consumes what it does not produce. But we cannot afford the luxury of resting on our laurels. We cannot afford the luxury of engaging in perpetual lamentation. I think that we can now, in the midst of COVID, recognize that this is an opportunity that we can seize. And I hope that this time round, we will not be accused of never being in the business, never being out of the business of missing an opportunity to miss an opportunity.
Why do African leaders subject their citizens to such a degree of suffering?
Let me say that number one, the wisdom that obtains in the world is that the people get the leaders that they deserve.
Can you repeat that, Professor?
Yeah, that we get the leaders that we deserve. We Africans have demonstrated consistently that when we are given an opportunity to elect individuals through the voting process, we elect men and women who promise us bridges to be built where there are no rivers. They promise us the sun, they promise us things, and we clap for them at public rallies. That is criteria number one, that we are very susceptible to manipulation. Number two, we have also demonstrated that when we are called upon to elect men and women into office, particularly because of our multi-ethnic nature, we are quick to choose people on the basis of our ethnic affiliation rather than the basis of the content of their character and their ability to deliver. And that is true of Zimbabwe as it is true in Zambia, as it is true in Kenya, or indeed in any other country. Of course, those who are listening to my answer will say, but they rig the elections. But even when they rig the elections, if they do, we do not come out in a sustained and sustainable manner to send a clear message. We have seen in other parts of the world, if you saw what happened, for example, in the Arab Spring, and in answering my question, I'm now making a distinction between the sub-Saharan Africa and the Maghreb. You saw when the Arab North was dissatisfied with their leadership in Tunisia, they came out and the leaders went. They came out in Egypt and the leaders went. They came out in Algeria and the leaders went. In Africa, except for Burkina Faso in the recent past, we have not demonstrated that we have the ability to do so. And in the countries where we have had change of leaders, whenever there has been mismanagement, we have seen it has been through armed struggle. That is how Mobutu Sese Seko was removed. That is how the genocidal regime in Rwanda was removed. That is how the Deg regime in Ethiopia of Mengistu Haile Mariam was removed. That is how Idi Amin was removed. But when it is left to the population is so docile, and the political leaders in Africa have recognized that our docility is our weakness, and therefore they can do anything they like with us. And when they find it fit, then they manipulate us on the basis of our ethnic affiliation. So we are co-authors of our own misfortune.
What are your views on Madagascar COVID-19 medicine that all African leaders are ignoring to talk or give them a chance as fellow African country?
I think what has happened with President Rajuel and the Madagascar people is something that has to be commended. I personally have gone out and said that that is something that ought to be appreciated and supported. Mm. What the people of Madagascar are saying is that we have discovered something that we hold the view is capable of dealing with COVID-19. The World Health Organization is asking, does it conform to the protocol that have been prescribed by the World Health Organization? But let us ask ourselves, who prescribed these protocols? It is Pfizer, which is a pharmaceutical company. It is Novartis, which is a pharmaceutical company. It is Johnson & Johnson, which is a pharmaceutical company. It is Roche, which is a pharmaceutical company. Why is it that when an African country discovers something, we don't scrutinize And we don't ask the question as to whether it can be potent. If indeed the Madagascans have discovered something, what we need to do is to ask ourselves if they have made baby steps. What can we do by dint of research in our universities and other research institutions to ensure that that particular concoction achieves the levels which are acceptable? And I'm very happy with the people of Equatorial Guinea and the people of Guinea-Bissau and now Tanzania who have come out and said we are going to try it. Because in any event, all these drugs that we consume so very gleefully from the West, the material, the raw material that is used as extracts are actually from Africa, among other places. So it is quite possible, and I have no doubt in my mind that what is being peddled by the people of Madagascar deserves scrutiny. To dismiss it offhand as we are doing is one of the things that we Africans like to do, to embrace with our folded hands that which comes from the West, India and other parts of the world, and to deride and to dismiss that which is from the continent of Africa. I'm also very happy with the Oni of Ife in Nigeria, who has also recommended that we ought to look into herbal medicine. And in this regard, even the government of Zimbabwe has gone out and said that that is one of the things that we ought to do. And is also not lost. Or the cabinet secretary for health in Kenya has also encouraged our premier institution in medical research to work with herbalists towards finding herbal medicine for COVID-19.
Yeah, so viewers, it seems Madagascar really has discovered the medicine to COVID-19, but it seems WHO is not giving the support. Okay, it seems WHO doesn't want Madagascar to go on with it. But as Africans, let us stand up for one another and give the support to Madagascar. Talk to your leaders, advise your leaders, all those that are connected to the politicians. Open their minds. Let this thing be carried on, you know. And that's all I heard. I believe most of you are saying, how come we don't have so much of your content? Because we were expecting you to say much in the video. Ladies and gentlemen, I'm actually going to say more in the next video, so don't forget to subscribe and hit the notification bell down below so that you get notified the next time I upload this video, because I was looking at time. I don't want to make this video so big, so I'm going to actually talk about this in the next video that I'm going to upload, probably some days to come. So it was actually nice having you sit in front of your gadget, your phone or whatever that it is that you are using to view me, and it's actually good having to spend some time together, you and I, and you viewing me and me talking to you. Ladies and gentlemen, don't forget to subscribe. From me, it's your boy T5. Peace out.